Several business groups and companies here in the Philippines back government's return to office policy. In a statement, officials of the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry, the Financial Executives Institute of the Philippines, and the Management Association of the Philippines said such a move is a significant step to the country's journey to post-pandemic recovery. The statement was also signed by officials of major mall operators Ayala Land, SM Prime, Mega World, and restaurant group Resto PH. This is in contrast to the appeal of the IT and Business Process Association of the Philippines, which is calling for an extension of the work-from-home arrangement for BPO workers. IBPAP is also urging for a shift to a hybrid work scheme where employees do not need to be in the office for an entire week.
Government cash aid to the poorest families in the Philippines to be increased by 300 pesos. President Rodrigo Duterte told Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez to hike the monthly assistance from 200 to 500 pesos. Lawmakers had criticized the original amount as a pittance. The cash aid is meant to help the poorest Filipinos cope with soaring fuel and commodity prices. Duterte says his finance chief had agreed to the increase, but adds Dominguez is doubtful if funds for the higher cash aid will be enough to last for 6 months. Duterte says he will leave it to the next administration to continue funding the aid distribution.
Gambling operator Charlie Atong Ang tagged in the abduction cases of several online cockfighting enthusiasts. During a Senate hearing on missing persons linked to Isabong, several witnesses also said at least two police officers were involved in kidnapping. They claimed Ang was pissed off by their game-fixing scheme.
Ang tawag niya po ay Boss A. Yung po ang ano po namin na sinasabi niya si Atong Ang po daw. Ang sabi po ay Boss A. May mga tao na naman dito na pumasok na mga manchochope. Ang sabi niya po, naka-loudspeaker po yung cellphone niya.
Kilala mong boses ni Atong?
Medyo malat po. Ang sabi po ni, nung tinawagan po niya, ang sabi po ay, sige, paaminin niyo kung sino ang boss. Pagka hindi niya inamin, patayin niyo na.
Ang denies the allegations and accused Laguna Police Chief Colonel Rogert Campo as the one who's trying to frame him for the disappearances.
Part of the conspiracy yan eh.
Ito si Colonel Rogert, sabi niya, boss, gusto mo dukutin na lang namin eh. Hindi ko alam kung nabibiro siya, seryoso, naghahanap kami ng kaso ng mga tao eh. Sino ba ang nasa likod ni Rogert? Siyempre, kalaban ko sa negosyo.
Hindi ko masasabing part ako sir. Yung sinasabi na makakalimutin ako, siguro sir, sasabihin ko, sleep of batang.
Ang is known as one of the so-called legal gambling lords in the country. His initial brush with controversy was in 2001 when his name was dragged in the Estrada impeachment trial.
Foreign companies are now allowed full ownership of telecommunications, railways, and airlines in the Philippines. President Rodrigo Duterte says this will fuel the country's economic recovery from the pandemic. When a false reports.
In an attempt to open up the economy even more to foreign businessmen, President Duterte signed on Monday Republic Act 11659, which amended the 85-year-old Public Service Act.
I believe that through this law, the easing of foreign equity restrictions will attract more global investors, modernize several sectors of public service, and improve the delivery of essential services.
The measure effectively opens up to 100% foreign equity across economic sectors, such as telecommunications, airlines, and railways. But the transmission and distribution of electricity, water pipeline and sewerage, seaports and petroleum pipeline, and public utility vehicles are still subject to a 40% foreign investment cap. Prior to the amendment, foreigners were restricted from full ownership of telecommunication firms. Analysts say this has stunted investment in telcos and resulted in a duopoly that is disadvantageous to consumers.
The impact of the PSA amendments on telecommunications in the country is quite clear. Now we can expect the industry to be open to companies, even those that are 100% foreign owned. And eventually we can expect more choices for the consumers, better services, innovation, as well as more affordable rates.
Well, it's an interesting development. It allows for foreign competition to enter the information communications technology space, right? And competition being the primary factor to lower costs and increase service quality, it's potentially a game changer for the country.
Trade Secretary Ramon Lopez earlier said the increase in competition will not only help generate better quality of services at more affordable prices, but also generate more jobs. House Ways and Means Committee Chair Joey Salceda sees an increase in foreign direct investments by around 299 billion pesos over the next 5 years. He adds there will be strong jobs growth in telecommunications, heavy transport, and other key public services as a result of foreign capital infusions. Wen Acos, ABS-CBN News.
The enactment of the revised Public Service Act is met with mixed reactions. The American Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines welcomes the move, calling it the most significant liberalization to welcome foreign investments in 30 years. It adds the measure, along with other key economic bills, will likely encourage large new inflows of foreign capital, create new jobs, and foster more competition in key industries. Philippine Senator Grace Poe says the measure will spur critical investments that would fast-track inclusive recovery and development in the Philippines. She adds they will remain vigilant in enforcing the safeguards of the law. Poe is the main author and sponsor of the Public Service Act, but Kabataan Party List Representative Sara Ilago believes the measure seeks to bypass the current constitutional limits on foreign ownership of public utilities. She asserts excessive foreign control over key industries could undermine national security and consumer privacy.